Hi people, welcome to Tots and Moms. Today I'm going to show you four barley recipes which are baby friendly, kid friendly, and two such recipes here which I'm showing that the whole family can have. So let's dive right in, and before that I want to tell you the benefits of barley. Barley is rich in dietary fiber and hence easily digestible. That's why it is suggested for babies. It boosts iron absorption. So somebody who is anemic in the family should always be suggested to have lots of barley recipes. It has antifungal properties. Barley strengthens bones, and there are lot more benefits which I have mentioned on my blog totsandmoms.com when it can be given, precautions if any, allergy scenarios, all those are mentioned. Please have a look at the blog. And without much ado, now we'll move on to make four recipes using barley. I'm taking barley. This is also called as jaw in Hindi. I have just rinsed it and immediately I'm adding it to a pan. If you wish, you can sun dry it as well, but for people who lack sunlight, this is the best way to roast grains. You just have to rinse it, immediately strain and add in here with minimal water as much as possible, and also quickly so that the grain doesn't soak much of the moisture. And on high flame, initial 2 minutes you will have to roast it, and then you can roast it on medium or low flame so that it is well roasted. 10 to 15 minutes is what it is taken to roast. Now we'll then transfer it to a plate, allow it to cool, and then make a fine powder out of this. As much as possible, don't be very keen on making fine powder because it is home mixer grinder or blender jar and it wouldn't give you better results, just like how you grind it in power machines in industry. So once you make a fine powder, as much as possible, we can transfer it into a glass jar or a steel box. Preferably these two are good and safe to store baby food. 2 to 4 months, sometimes till 6 months also, this can stay good. And it's good to have 2-3 porridge options at home. When you are in hurry, you can use these cereal or porridge mixes and cook porridge for your baby quickly. Now the method of making barley porridge. I'm adding a spoonful of barley cereal, about 1 tablespoon. Now I'm adding water or milk. It's always good to make a lump-free mixture before putting it on flame, especially when you are cooking any of the porridges. I'll switch on the flame and cook it for about 3 to 5 minutes. As it's already well roasted, keep stirring the mixture. To flavor it, we can add any easily digestible spices which are not too spicy for baby, like cumin powder, cardamom powder, or cinnamon powder. These are three spices which can be initially added for baby when you are introducing spices to them. You can even add any fruit or vegetable puree. Ensure that you keep stirring, otherwise there are chances that the porridge sticks to the bottom of the pan. Now barley porridge is all ready to be served. You may find it little thin now, but once it cools down, it will be as thick as something good for baby. And always I suggest to serve thick porridges, thick soups for babies, because too much of a liquid would really not be good for babies. So here we move on to our next recipe, barley apple porridge. This can be given to 6 months and above babies. A great combination of barley and apple. Apple enhances the flavor and it is great for babies as a first food. In a pressure cooker, I'm adding ghee, followed by barley, which I have soaked prior. This must be soaked for at least 4 to 5 hours or over a night is good. Mix it, any grain when you add with ghee and roast it, it really gives good result, good taste. Once done, I am adding diced apple here. Stir it a bit again. And now we'll add water. You can even add milk. It would give a kheer-like consistency and taste if you are cooking it in milk. We'll then add cinnamon powder. Mix it well. Close the lid and now we'll pressure cook it for about 3 whistles. Sometimes it takes a lot of time, so 3 to 5 whistles is okay. And also we want well cooked barley for baby, so that must be safe enough. Once the pressure is released, just check if it is well cooked. If not, you can continue to cook it further. With the help of an immersion blender, now I am sort of pureeing it a bit, but I'll still keep some texture. You can even grind it in a mixer jar. So barley apple porridge is all ready to be served. This even adults can have. Somebody who likes to have an evening snack with baby can have this as well. So barley apple porridge, second recipe is done. The third one, barley moong khichdi. I have mentioned it as 8 months preferably for somebody who's not been introduced to lentils and spices yet. But if you have introduced this moong dal, most of them introduce at 6 months only. So that's fine to give at 6 months, but you decide it. In a pressure pan, I'm adding ghee followed by curry leaves, soaked barley. I have mentioned it as 4 hours. Moong dal, this just can be rinsed and added. You don't have to soak it. Just like barley, it's not necessary because moong cooks very quickly, just on 1 or 2 whistles as well sometimes. Yeah, so give it a quick mix. And now we'll add spices: turmeric powder, black pepper powder, cumin powder. You can add in any spice of your choice. You can even add jeera initially if you like or your baby likes. Most of babies, at least mine, used to spit out jeera, so I have skipped adding it and I have added cumin powder here. We'll then add water. Give a quick stir. Cook it for 3 whistles. To make or prepare barley, any of barley recipes, it's good to pressure cook it. Otherwise, it will take a lot of time when you cook it in the pan. Lot of power consumption or lot of gas consumption will also happen. So it's always good to use pressure cooker, and it's mostly baby friendly to have one small pressure cooker, right, to make any of the baby food. So our barley moong khichdi is done. If you wish, you can mash it with the help of a spoon and serve it to your baby. For younger babies, if you have not at all given textures, you can blend it as well. So barley moong khichdi is all ready. Fourth and last recipe, I have given 2 variations here: barley vegetable soup. This is the baby version, and this is the adult version, or even kids can have it. You can make it for the whole family, for kids and adults. It makes a great diet food as well for somebody who is checking on weight loss. Can have it in the morning because it keeps them full for a longer time. I've added soaked barley, peas, potato, chopped carrot. You can add any vegetables of your choice. Broccoli. Sorry, there is a spelling mistake here. I'm now adding water, sufficient enough to cook barley and vegetables. Not adding any spices before cooking it. So we'll just close the lid and pressure cook it for 3 to 5 whistles. Once done, keep it aside to cool and then we'll start making the versions we want. Baby version if you want to make, then we'll take a scoop or two of barley and vegetable mixture, add it in a blender jar and make a fine puree. Once done, I'll heat a pan. Add a bit of ghee. You can add cumin seeds now if you wish. I'm adding the pureed mixture. We'll saute it in ghee for about a minute or two. Just like puree, you can serve the mixture, but if you want to make a soup version of it, then this is the procedure. I'm adding a little more water, just a bit more. Don't make it too thin. Keep stirring it. Once it's thickening, then you can add cumin powder. Pepper powder. You can even add turmeric powder if you wish. While cooking barley and vegetables, you can even add 1 or 2 pods of garlic. Stir it and done. You don't have to overcook it. So our barley vegetable soup, the baby version, is all ready to be served. The next one is the adult version of the same barley vegetable soup. I'm taking a pan. I'm adding ghee. Cumin seeds, barley and vegetable mixture. As these are already cooked, you just have to bring it to boil before adding the spices. I'm adding salt. Yes, the only recipe I'm adding salt is this because it is an adult version. Babies don't need salt till an year. Pepper powder, turmeric powder, cumin powder also I've added, I guess. Yeah, we'll give it a quick stir, boil it for a minute or two until barley and vegetable absorb the spices, and then it's all ready to be served. Barley vegetable soup, our fourth recipe. So the measurement and ingredients of all the items I've used in these recipes would be given on our blog. Please check that, which is in the description, the link. And thank you so much for watching these recipes. I hope you like these and you will make them for yourself and baby especially. As said earlier, please have a look at the blog where the details, benefits of barley, when it can be given, etc. is mentioned. Thanks again. Take care. Bye-bye.